NFL player dared to kneel at game after deadly shooting, gets wrecked seconds after he gets up. With a Monday Night Football game mashup less than 24 hours after the deadliest mass shooting in our country's modern history, there was some question as to who would carry on the season's sick tradition of protesting our national anthem. The Washington Redskins and Kansas City Chiefs were set to play against each other, and any remaining football fans waited to see which players from either team would take a knee or do anything disrespectful. By the time the teams took the field for the game, 59 Americans had been declared dead. On a quick scan of the sidelines during the anthem, it appeared that all Redskins and Chiefs had stood in respect for our country and remembrance of the lives lost the night before. Then one camera cut to the Chiefs bench and caught what their cornerback Marcus Peters was doing. With a complete disregard for the somber moment and 59 lives lost just hours earlier, Pates had a point he wanted to make and didn't care who it offended. All this player proved is that he had no clue what he was protesting and is as disrespectful as it gets. Unlike past games this season and multiple players protesting, others on the field and in the stadium last night weren't so understanding of Peter's message, as the NFL commissioner urged everyone to be early on in the season. With added insult to the disrespectful gesture, Peters went further than taking a knee. He didn't even budge from the bench and simply remained seated the entire time, thinking only of himself when he should have realized how disgusting he was being. Seconds after standing up and heading to the field to play, he got the brutal lesson he deserved, which will hopefully make him think twice about kneeling or sitting next time. Peters played probably one of his worst games yet, as he got burned badly by a player on the opposite team when going for a 44-yard touchdown. It looked painful and was the perfect punishment for showing complete disrespect for the lives lost in Las Vegas the night before. It seems that Peters is now in the minority among NFL players. Following President Donald Trump's strong remarks against national anthem protests, roughly 180 NFL players refused to stand for the national anthem, Independent Journal Review reported. This week, the number apparently dropped to 54. That was after, of course, NFL fans made it clear they did not support taking a knee during the national anthem, IJ Review added. It shouldn't take a tragedy like this one in Las Vegas over the weekend to bring a country together and stop these protests. However, it should provide a reality check for these entitled football players and those who support their kneeling. The stated purpose of not standing for the national anthem is protests' supposed police brutality on the black community in the United States. The player leading the charge this season was Seahawks Michael Bennett, who added to his cause after a weekend in Vegas when he was stopped by cops. Bennett claimed that excessive force was used against him by Las Vegas police when that was later determined not to be the case. Ironically, those same cops who were just doing their job when they stopped Bennett that weekend were also at the concert this weekend after the shooting. They didn't discriminate against a single victim or ask them what their political beliefs were or feelings toward officers when they were picking them up off the ground and rushing people to safety. The only questions police asked people that night is how they can help and what hurts. While players take a knee to protest police, cops show up to work every single day to help. We can do without entitled sports stars paid millions to play a game, but we can't survive without these badged heroes who do a selfless job in society. Not a single football player was seen running into the war zone outside Mandalay Bay, but countless police officers were there braving the hailstorm of gunfire. Not a single NFL player should be allowed to kneel the rest of the season. This is a statement and rule that Commissioner Roger Goodell should come out and say, out of respect for all 59 lives lost in Las Vegas and the loved ones who can't get them back. It's time to move on past this misguided message and recognize that police have an exceptionally difficult job to do, and without them, there would have likely been many more victims.